So I was watching Techmoan a couple of weeks ago, and he had a rather unusual cartridge player. This is what it looked like, and it was an import from Japan. With Japan, they've got 50 hertz and 60 hertz supply, and the one he got was 60 hertz. That's the way it was set up. And when he was looking on the inside of it, he saw this capacitor in there, and just above it, it said to change the capacitor depending on what frequency you're using. So essentially, he needed to change the capacitor for one microfarad, if I remember right, to run it on 50 hertz. So I thought, yeah, he wasn't sure about doing it, so I thought I'd make this video to highlight it. Now, I've got an Akai 1710, and it's a reel-to-reel tape recorder, but it shares the same sort of ideas. And I've got a friend who collects Akai tape recorders, and we've been doing a lot of fault finding with some of the ones he's got. So I've been quite well knowledge on this this particular circuit, or circuit similar to this. So here's the circuit inside mine, and what you'll notice there is the motor. This is where the supply comes in, and one side of that supply goes round, and it's common to all these coils. The other side goes to this rail here, and there's a switch there to select between high and low speed. Basically, these coils is a two pole and a four pole winding. The two pole is the high speed and the four pole is the low speed. So with a switch selected in one direction, in this particular case it's on low speed, that's on one coil, the other coil comes through to one capacitor and back to the supply. The other capacitor is not directly connected, it actually goes down to this connector, and across the other side here, that goes up through a switch, and at the moment it's set for 50 cycles. So that switch is joined, and it comes back through here and onto this bottom rail. For 60 hertz, that switch is open, so this capacitor gets disconnected, and the value of that capacitor is 2 microfarads, and they're adding 0.5 microfarad capacitor across that. So let's take a look at that in reality, slightly redrawn circuit. And on this diagram here, this is the simplest explanation for the circuit, and you can see that one winding goes directly to the mains, which is coming on the left hand side, and the other one goes through a capacitor. That capacitor basically shifts the phase a little bit, delayed or advanced, I can't remember, but it shifts the phase angle slightly. So these windings essentially are sort of 90 degrees to each other, so that, yeah, one will come into operation and the other one will come into the operation through the capacitor. If you didn't have that second winding, it would just sit there and do nothing. If you spin the motor by hand, it will go in whichever direction you start it. Not very well, but it'll go in that direction. Incidentally, while we're on this particular circuit, if you ever want to reverse it, all you do is you just reverse one of the windings, like this. And that will set it going in the opposite direction. So, I think we need to demonstrate this in actual terms. So I'll just reset the camera angles on that, and I'll be back in a minute. So what we've got here is a desk fan. It's the only motor I could find that's capacitor run, that's a reasonable size. So I've also got the speed counter. So we turn the fan on. I've got a marker on the back. Try and get this in shot for you. That's going about 750 RPM. The capacitor on there is a 1 microfarad, and I've got a couple of half microfarads here. I've wired them in series because these are only 250 volt rating, and I've wired them in series to give me a 500 volt rating. And now if I turn the fan on, speed is about 950-960, which is about right for a difference. If you're going from a 60 hertz to a 50 hertz, you need to make the fan go faster or the motor go faster. So adding capacitance, which is what Tech Moment would have had to done, would make the motor go faster and bring it in line with the using it on 50 hertz. There was at least one comment, a friend who collects the tape recorders brought my attention to. That was someone that mentioned capacitors only work on DC for speed control. Capacitors will only pass AC or pulse DC, but generally it's, yeah, pulse DC is the same as AC. Doing anything with a capacitor on a DC circuit won't change the speed. It's only on AC, on induction motors. So I hope that's answered the question, and hope that Techmoan changes the capacitor for the 1 microfarad as it shows on the tag strip.